Mama, you said you put somebody in God's hands? What better hands can you put him in? Come on, somebody. Sometimes God might put him in jail. Sometimes God might put him on their bed. Sometimes God may allow something to happen in their life to bring their focal point back to him. Imagine this man being stoned almost to death for the word of God. Some of y'all get y'all feeling hurt and you want to cry. Come on, somebody. You know, many offenses are going to come. The Bible said, woe to whom offenses may come. Jesus said, and rebuked even the disciple and those that were among them to suffer little children to come unto me, for such is the kingdom of heaven. God said, it would have been better to have a millstone tied about thy neck and cast into the sea than to offend one of my little ones. A millstone was a stone that used to crush olives, to get the olive oil, to extract the juice out of the olive. And God said that thing weighs about 150 pounds. Some of y'all men folks can bench press 250, 300 pounds. Come on, somebody. Me? Come on, somebody. I'm just going to lift up the 10 pounds. Because they ain't trying to build no muscle. Them days are all gone. Amen? All I'm trying to do is maintain what God gave me. Amen? And whatever it takes, I'm going to keep it in shape. Look at somebody and say,
whatever it takes,
I'm going to keep it in shape.
I'm going to keep it in shape.
Some of y'all let gravity get the best of you. I'm going to leave y'all alone right now. If you remain faithful, the Holy Ghost will tell you when to exercise.
That's right.
The Holy Ghost will tell you what you need to do. Amen. Right. All you got to do is listen to the Spirit when it calls.
That's right. Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Not by might. Some folks try to live for God by might.
Yes.
Some try to live for God by power. Yes. Come on, somebody. So a lot of folks got might, and a lot of folks got power. And I know some folks got power and they be power tripping. Yeah. Did I say that right? I didn't say nothing wrong, because I know folks, you know folks, we both know the same folks that are power tripping. You give them a little authority and power and go straight to their head. They want to tell everybody, including the boss man, what to do. They get mad when somebody has to sit them down. They get mad when they have to be corrected because they want power tripping. Don't let power go to your head. Not by might, not by power, but by my spirit. God says, by my spirit, the Holy Ghost will whip God from the beginning. It's always been faithful unto God. When God says something, the Spirit went out and did it. Don't ask me how it was done, because I'm like you, I'm still in this realm, trying to figure out how things get done. But when God speak it, going to come to pass. If God said you're healed, by my stripes you're healed, you can claim it. All we're going to do is remain faithful. When God said he will wipe away all your sin, remain faithful. See, there are a lot of people, you might not believe this, but there are a lot of people who in their mindset think that they can just get the Holy Ghost any kind of way.
No, no. Oh, no.
Y'all look at me like that. I know what I'm talking about. The Bible said in the scripture, there was a young girl that had a spirit of divination. That spirit wasn't divine. It was a divinating spirit. It was a fortune-telling spirit. And all folks want to know their fortune. Come on, somebody. They go to the tea reading. You know what I'm talking about. You go in there, look at a cup, how the leaves are set in the cup after you drank the tea, and left the leaves in there, and folks will tell you something. All I see is some dried up leaves out of the cup. They see something I don't see, amen. But when you lay that green on the table, all of a sudden they see a whole lot of that. The more green you put on the table, the more things they see. Y'all with me on this? It's the same with them with that crystal ball. Come on, somebody. Drop a 50 spot. Oh, yes, come in real quick. Come in real quick. Oh, yeah. I see something beautiful. somebody, man, they gonna beat you out of what you got. And he's nice looking, or she's not attractive. She's a 5'9" to the 9.9. Anything that's got breath and riches.
That's right, breath and
riches. Come on, somebody. Wait on the Lord. Somebody should be faithful and wait on the Lord. But this young girl was being pimped by her master. Somebody said, I'm telling it like it is. She had a fortune telling spirit. She could tell you about yourself, but she was too young and too dumb. Figure it out. So it took another man and took advantage of the situation. Yes. And he started pimping her for money.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
Y'all don't hear that kind of talk in church. That's too undignified. But I'm going to tell it to you like here. Because it's right in the 16th chapter of Acts.
Yes.
I just want you to see that this woman was fortune telling. Uh-huh. And I want you to understand that she found the men of God.
Uh-huh.
Preaching the gospel. Paul was preaching left and right, up and down, in the temple, in the city. Everywhere that Paul went, she followed Paul and the men of God.
Amen.
Y'all look, have the men of God that bring salvation and bring the word of God to us. She did that for about 4 or 5 days. Then the Spirit of God got on Paul. Because Paul was full of the Holy Ghost.
Right.
He tolerated for a few days. But then he got tired of that devil. Come on, somebody. Sometimes I don't know about you, but when the devil rides you like a monkey riding your back, tell him it's time to get off.
Right.
It's time to rebuke and bind him.
Yeah.
This young girl kept on talking. She kept on talking. She kept on following him. She kept on aggravating him. And sooner or later, Paul got fed up.
Amen.
And Paul turned around to the young damsel that had a fortune-telling spirit that could see things into the future, that can talk to the dead as well as the living. He said, Spirit, in the name of Jesus Christ, I adjure you to come out of her.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The Bible said that self-same hour, that spirit came out. Now this is the issue. The issue where the girl was once being pimped, she ain't being pimped.
Come
on, somebody. When God saved you, ain't nobody can pimp you no more. When God bless you, give you the baptism of the Holy Ghost, ain't nobody come in and try to tell you what to do.
No way. Amen.
All you got to do is when you got the Spirit and be faithful,
that's right.
God will see you through the rest.
Oh, yes, amen.
Yes, amen.
I love you. Amen.
Amen.
Well, now, that one too. That didn't go too well with the master. The Bible said the master, this young girl, got so upset, he took Paul and Silas to the magistrate, to the jailhouse, the courthouse, accused them that they were nothing but troublemakers. The other young girl that got delivered from demons, now she didn't have troublemakers. I think the real troublemakers is the one who was pimping. All these things are going your way. Come on, somebody. Things are all right. There's a lot of folks being pimped today. Amen. They don't even realize they've been used and abused. And all you got to do is remain faithful unto the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
You got to do the rest. Amen. It'll reveal things to you that you were once trying to.
Amen.
They're trying to say, Pastor, I'm saying that this master got so mad, he turned him into the jail. Even the magistrate didn't want to hear nothing that Paul and Silas had to say. The Bible said they started whooping them. They started beating them.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. Knocking them down, spitting on them. And then they throw them in jail. Didn't even give them a chance to explain that they were wrong. Let me tell you something. After you've been whooped, after being used and abused, and you still remain faithful, God will see you through. God will take you from one level to the next if you remain faithful unto Him.
Amen. Amen.
Can you imagine Amen. Paul and Silas? There's an old hymn that said Paul and Silas was in a Roman jail. And they didn't have nobody else to pull their bed. But if the boys was here today, they would stand right up and say that Jesus can make a way.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.